Hey guys, and welcome back. Thank you guys so much for checking out my YouTube channel again. It really means the entire world to me. If you guys would be so very kind and click that red subscribe button down below. Click that bell in the corner so you're notified every time I post a new video. And make sure to give this video a thumbs up while you're down there. So today I decided to do a video where I talk about conspiracy theories because I am a theorist. Why, of course. These are some that really fuck me up and really give life a whole new meaning. I've experienced almost all of these, and it's just crazy to think that I totally believe in parallel universes. I totally believe that at some point we, you know, change directions and the Earth we know is not the Earth we know. So yeah, let's get into the video. First off, the Nelson Mandela effect. Nelson Mandela was a guy back a while ago. I remember him dying while I was in middle school. I remember learning about him and reading about him dying in a prison in middle school. But apparently he never died and he's still quite alive today. The Nelson Mandela effect is when something, a lot of people, like millions of people, remember it one way. And then that way that people remember it, it was never even that way when you go back and try to, you know, piece together and figure out if you're losing your fucking mind. The first one I'm going to talk about is the Berenstain Bears. I am very familiar with these types of books. I used to read them along with that mouse looking rat looking thing, Arthur. They used to go hand in hand in my childhood. The Berenstain Bears. A lot of people remember the Berenstain Bears being called the Berenstain Bears, E-I-N, not A-I-N. I messaged my aunt about this a couple weeks ago, and she actually found one of the old books and screenshotted it to me, and it's A-I-N, not E-I-N. And that just fucks me up because I remember it vividly being E-I-N and Berenstain. Berenstain? No, fuck you. It's Berenstain Bears. The next one I'm going to talk about is, do you guys remember the Parent Trap? Parent Trap. It was a remake of the 19-something-something version where the two girls had blonde hair and it was really short. This one is the Lindsay Lohan remake. I think it was 1990-something, 96, 94, 97, something like that. It was like 20-some years ago. And I believe she played an 11-year-old girl who had a twin that they got separated at birth when their parents split. And they ended up reuniting at a camp that they ended up becoming best friends at and brought their parents together, and they all lived fucking happily ever after. Back then, there was no way that, back then the graphics weren't as good, the CG wasn't that good. There's no way that they could have had, you know, they could have taken one person, Lindsay Lohan, and made it look like she had another twin without there actually being a twin. So the conspiracy theory is that Lindsay Lohan actually had a fucking twin, you know, growing up, and they, you know, both did that movie and something bad happened to the twin. She passed away or, you know, came down with an illness, and Lindsay Lohan just kind of had to, you know, move on with her life and, you know, kind of forget about her twin, which is very sad if that is true. None of these things I'm saying is true. It's just for quality and entertainment purposes. The next one I'm going to talk about, it's kind of a conspiracy theory, but not really, because I kind of believe it's true. On airlines, you know, when the little stewardess bitch walks down the aisle, she's like, oh, if a plane is crashing, please interlock your fingers behind your head and place your head in between your knees. Well, my friends, that is not entirely true to save you. That position will actually cause you to break your neck and die instantaneously as the plane is crashing into the ocean or into land or whatever you might be crashing into. Also, the flotation devices, the life jackets or life whatevers that come down and they're like, oh, put this around your neck or head so, you know, you can float and be alive. Those are actually not to save you. Those are actually to keep your body floating after you have died. Hello, the position is gonna kill you anyway. So if you crash into the ocean, you die, you have the flotation device around your neck. This allows your body to float and stay at the top of the surface of the ocean so they can find your body. The position that they have you interlock your hands behind your neck and put your face in between your knees is so that when you crash and break your neck, your teeth are still completely visible, completely intact, and they can identify who you are. The next one I have for y'all is Beyonce was supposedly killed in a bad car accident in 2000, a while back, didn't want anything to happen to her, or if something happened to her, her record label was like, hey, like, let's put some of your DNA aside, so if anything happens, you know, we can still make money off of you, you know, you can still be famous. And so people are saying that she was cloned with her DNA, of course, in 2000 after a bad car accident, which I don't know if I fully believe this one, but it's kind of sketchy because in all the pictures before 2000, she was always smiling, she always looked happy. And if you put her face next to the pictures before 2000 and after 2000, there are some differences in her facial structure. Her mouth's not the same, her nose isn't the same, her eyes look different. I don't know. There's also a video of her and her husband at a basketball game, and she kind of looked like she was just, you know, kind of hanging out. The video was just her doing this for 5 minutes. I don't know, kind of creepy if you ask me. Okay, all these are just in good entertainment fun. And if you guys would be so very kind, give this video a thumbs up, click the little fucking bell in the corner so you're notified every time I post a new video. Make sure to follow all my social media down below, and I'll see you guys next time. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye!